Hello everyone, I am Snows, your host for Boot Sequence, and if it's your birthday, well, happy birthday. Roll the intro. It seems like everyone likes bundles these days. With Intel announcing their Core Plus bundles last week, we now have the AMD Combat Crate bundles that were just announced. What is interesting is that these bundles will have last gen Ryzen processors in them. The more affordable bundle will have a Ryzen 5 1600, an MSI B350 Tomahawk motherboard, and an MSI Gaming RX 580 8GB graphics card. These bundles don't seem to add any kind of significant discount. In fact, when you take a look at the pricing, the 580 is $40 lower than what is on retail, but still $60 over MSRP. But when you think about it, that might not be what AMD is after. Maybe this is one of the steps that they're taking to help with the whole mining crisis. By making a bundle with their GPUs, they're ensuring that a larger number of those cards get in the hands of gamers and DIY enthusiasts. But when you think about it, I mean, you get a 2-year-old GPU and a 1-year-old CPU for about the same price, if not a little more than you would have paid back then. But at the same time, it allows for more stable and consistent pricing. So what do you think? Would you bundle up or would you prefer to buy separate and newer? Let me know down below. I'd love to know your opinion. Now, we're not done with AMD just yet. It seems their APUs are getting a slim band put in because AMD just released the new low power APUs for desktops. The Ryzen 3 2200GE and the Ryzen 5 2400GE are 35 watt variants of their non-E counterparts. To make that happen, not only did AMD have to make them more power efficient, but they also needed to cut down on their clocks too. The Ryzen 5 version gets a 400 MHz dip to its base clock and a 300 MHz dip on the Ryzen 3 version. Boost clocks are not that affected, I think it's 100 MHz each. These APUs seem like they will only be available for system integrators for now, although with ASUS updating all of their BIOSes to support these new APUs, we might see them hit retail at some point. I used to not care about power consumption on computers at all, but as the years go by, I'm getting more and more interested in highly efficient computing. I mean, I guess at some point, I'll probably want to build a gaming PC in my car or something crazy like that. All right, let's move on to some short Intel news. In a recent Rapid Storage Technologies driver update, Intel indirectly confirmed their upcoming Z390 and X399 chipset. The 9th generation processors that will be available with this chipset will probably be the Cannon Lake CPUs with compatibility with the older Coffee Lake S. All right, now that we got AMD and Intel news out of the way, it's time for In Case You Didn't Know. Apple has just released iTunes on the Microsoft Store. While this doesn't seem like much, this is a pretty cool addition to the whole platform. While all of us with regular Windows 10 can just download the app from Apple's website, there are some Windows users who can't. Do you remember when Microsoft announced Windows 10 S mode, a sort of protected Windows version that can only download supported Windows Stores app? Well, this would be the only way for people on that OS to download iTunes. That or they can pay the extra $50 to Microsoft to update their license to full Windows 10. Moving on to Snapchat news, we got the new Spectacles version 2.0. Really, they're just the exact same except with incremental upgrade. It's lighter, it has higher resolution, it has a smaller case that goes with it, and it can take pictures, which I can't believe it could before. While it does have faster transfer speed and some extras, it's hard to justify buying something like that for 150 bucks. Also, in Snapchat, we've got some new ads coming. You've probably seen them after you watched a Snapchat show or after a story from your friends, and so far, you could always skip them by just swiping them away. But at the start of next month, they will test 6-second unskippable ads to try and up their revenue. Those ads will only appear on some of Snapchat's exclusive shows and not on your friends' stories or in the Discovers tab. What do you think? Are you still using Snapchat? I stopped a while ago and I only use it occasionally to talk to some friends in group chats. Honestly, I used to use it way more with the old UI and I just completely stopped when they changed everything. Speaking of ads, Facebook made an ad about how bad it has become. It's a simple 1-minute video about what was right, what went wrong, and how Facebook feels about all the problems it faced in the last few years. Link down below if you want to check out the video. It's actually pretty interesting. And last but not least, we've been tracking them and they've finally hit. The Fortnite meteors are hitting the map pretty much everywhere. While it doesn't affect gameplay, hell, it doesn't even do damage if it hits you directly. It seems like this is all coming together for the end of Season 3. Thanks to this tweet from Fortnite Games, we'll probably have more info at the start of Season 4. And now it's time for you to know a little bit more about me. Usually I give you a fun fact, but this time I want to show you something I made. This is a super high-powered LED light that I made a few years ago using a voltage booster, an old AMD CPU cooler, literally, wood, and foam. And it can turn your night into day. I'll give you an example. Well, actually, no. I'm just going to hook it up right here. Turned on. Now I'm going to put the joystick on. I'm gonna turn it on all the way. And is it all the way? I'm not even sure. It's a little broken. You see that? Turns, it's like a sunbeam. It's crazy. Anyways, that's pretty much it for the video, guys. Have yourselves a great day. Click here to watch the latest video and right here to subscribe to the channel. That would be greatly appreciated. If you have any questions, leave them down below and I will answer. And yeah, I can't believe this battery's not dead yet. It's like 6 years old.